Happy morning to each one of you, dear students. I am Vamna Advani, your English teacher. Welcome you all, dear students, for your English period today. In the previous video, students, we had done with lesson number 2, wherein we had recapitulated successfully about the present tense and specifically divide categories of simple present tense and present continuous tense. We also looked about the letter writing, the homework which I had given you all, and soon I'm going to give you a homework on letter writing question. So it will be shared to you via Prisms. The question will be shared to you via Prisms. And students, many of you all have yet not uploaded your notes and the worksheets in the respective drive in the folders. So please do it as soon as possible. In few days, I will also be discussing the names of the students who have not yet shared the worksheets and assignments with me. Okay. So let's begin our day. Yes. Take a Wiley textbook in your hand, students. Take pencil and an eraser. I'll give you 10 seconds. Be ready. And you will open your textbooks to page number 23. Today, we are going to look chapter number 3. As I said, listening and the speaking I'll be taking after some time. So let's focus on the reading and the usage of English, students. So please open your textbooks to page number 23 and be ready, students. Yes, students, here we go with the textbook, page number 23. Now we have done phrasal verbs, students. So this question number 5, we are going to discuss, okay? So let's read what the question is trying to say and what we have to do. The phrasal verbs in italics are to do with travel. So the phrasal verbs which are given, they are something related to the specific theme of traveling. Okay, that is very clearly mentioned. Match each phrasal verb in sentence A to H with one of the meanings, that is 1 to 8 given below. So A to H are your phrasal verbs and below you have the meanings, that is from 1 to 8. So you have to match the phrasal verbs, that is from A to H, with their meanings from 1 to 8. So let us begin, students. In front of A over here, you will write the answers as and when I'm discussing with you all. And need not worry, students. I will also be displaying the answers at the end as we do it. So starting with first, when we go to the hotel, we went to the reception to check in. Right? You go to the hotel to check in. So which one do you feel, students? It is 7th one, that is to register at your accommodation. Accommodation means when you go to stay somewhere. So check in at the hotel, the person is checking in, he is registering for his own accommodation, for his own staying. So it is 7. A is 7. Next, Paolo decided he really needed to get away to somewhere hot where he could rest and relax. So when do people go for relaxing, students? They go basically when they are on holidays. So let us look for holiday from 1 to 8. Yes, it is the 6th one. So answer for B is 6. So just besides this sentence over here, students, you all are going to write 6. Next, the plane is supposed to get in at about 10. So get in means to arrive at a destination. Okay, so it is 1. So answer C is 1. Next, Dr. Lee set off from his house around 6 this morning in order to catch his flight. So what do you think, students? Any guesses? Think. Dr. Lee set off. Set off means to begin something. Okay, so it is 8th one. So the answer for D is 8, students, to begin the journey. E, when we fly to Japan, we usually stop over in Delhi. You all have seen connecting flights. You all might have even traveled students that if you all are going from, say, Pune to Delhi, you have a connecting flight or you have a halt, suppose of the flight in Mumbai. Supposing in Mumbai. So it is the fourth one. To stay somewhere for a short time when you are going somewhere else. Now suppose if you have to board a flight to Delhi, so you stop, your flight has a stop in middle, suppose in Mumbai. So you stay there for some time. F1. When the family went to the travel agency, the travel agent booked them into a hotel on the coast for 2 weeks. So it is to arrange for someone to stay. Okay. So what is the question saying? That the family went to the travel agency and they arranged for the accommodation for them to stay in a hotel. So F is fifth. Now G, all hotel guests must check out by midday. So what is the answer? It is to pay and leave the accommodation. When you check out, students, suppose you are staying into a hotel and when you check out at that time, you pay the bill and you leave the accommodation, you leave the hotel. So it is 3. And last, H1, students, please go to gate 14 as the plane to Lisbon is due to take off in about 30 minutes. Take off means to leave the ground. So it is number 2. When the plane takes off, it moves, it is above the ground. It takes off above the ground. So it is to leave the ground. I hope that you all have written, students. Now, on the right hand side, these are the collocations. Now, what you are supposed to do, I'm going to display the answers for it, students. Please don't write it right now because it won't be fitting over there. Link the verbs in A with the suitable nouns in box B. There is sometimes more than one answer. Do the same words go together in your language? Now, many times we say, suppose, take. This is the verb. And you have to match with the noun over here. For example, take a trip. Take a ship. Yes? So, for one verb, it is possible that you can have more than one or two nouns from the bracket or from the option B. So, I'm going to display the answers for the students. Please don't write, but understand how you're going to do it. Book a trip, book a ship, book a plane, right? Book flight. Please book a flight for me, right? You'll say it into your day-to-day language, in your day-to-day communication. Next, catch flight, catch a ship, okay, board plane, board a trip, yes. So in this way, you have to collocate the verb from bracket from the box A with the noun in the box B. Now, question number 7, students. The task below is similar to what simpler than the one you all have done in reading and usage of English paper. Decide which answer, that is A or B, best fits each gap. Now, students, you all can see that there is an extract over here and you have blanks in the extract and your work is to complete those blanks. So when you have to complete the blank, students, when you go down, for each blank, number of blanks, suppose one, the number of blank is 8, suppose over here. Okay, so you have 2 options. Now, students, you have to select that which option is suitable for filling that blanks. So let us do it together. It's about an extract or a text on history of airports. Okay, the earliest aircraft took off and landing - were in fields or on dirt tracks. So which one, students, from A and B? It is A. So you're going to put a tick over here and you're going to write the word sites over here in the blank. Please don't forget to write the word, okay? In the examinations also, you're going to write the word in the blank and you're also going to put a tick whether it is A, B, C or D, how much ever option is given to you. When it came to landing, a plane could dash at any angle. So the option is the plane could approach. So it is B. The plane could approach at any angle depending on wind direction. However, wheels and tracks only functioned well in dry conditions. In order to dash year-round landings, concrete surfaces would be necessary. So let's go to the third option and see. It is allow. Okay. In order to allow year-round. The word airport dash in a New York Times article in 1902. It appeared. Okay. So option B is the answer. The word airport appeared in a New York Times article in 1902, where it was dashed that New York was expected to be the main world airport within 20 years. So let's go to the fifth one, students. It stated, okay, the appropriate usage is stated. However, there were competitions for this title as a number of other airports such as Bremen Airport in Germany and Rome, Ciampino in Italy began to open in the 1920s. Today, the world's busiest airport is Hartsfield-Jackson Atlanta International, which is in the United States. The airport has 151 dash and 28 international gates. So the airport has, the airport has 151 domestic, okay, and 28 international gates and two terminals where passengers dash for their flights, where passengers check in for their flight. So it is A. Yes. I hope that you all have written the answers. Now turn your page to 24 and we are going to study about modals. Okay. So let us see. Before we go with the exercise, I want you all to just recall once again the modals of obligation. So here we go. Yes. So we are going to study about obligation. Okay. So we have to understand what's the difference between when we talk about must, have to, mustn't. All these are the modals which comes under giving permission or giving an obligation. So each modal has its own unique meaning. So let us understand each meaning in detail, students. So first one, we will talk about must. What is must, as how it is being used as a modal? Must is used to express personal obligation, a personal suggestion on your level. Someone, some other authority person is not coming and telling you. On a personal level, like your friend or your family members who recommend, who give you the suggestions. Okay, so it is on the very personal level. For example, you must visit a doctor if you're not well. Or I must go to the bed earlier. So it's a personal obligation. No one in authority is coming and telling, hey, you must go there. No, it's your personal obligation. Second, have to. Okay, it expresses impersonal obligation. Impersonal means some person in the authority or some external power has given you that obligation that you have to complete or you have to do the action. For example, I have to arrive at work sharp at 9 a.m. So this is not given to you by the friend, but this might be given to you by the boss where you are working or in the school where you are studying. You have to report to school at 7:45 a.m. Okay. So, have to as a modal, which comes under obligation, you use it when some person as the power who is telling you to follow the rules or some laws. Okay. Next, Next modal is, mustn't over here. Okay. Mustn't. It is prohibited or it is not allowed. Okay. When we say, you all have seen the signs on the road, students, right? Horn ka, that is, or even no parking, if you can, if you say, you know, you have a P and then it is circle and crossed. So you mustn't park your car here. Okay. So it's not allowed. It's prohibited. It's completely banned. So when you have to express something which is completely banned, which is completely prohibited, there you use the obligation of modal as mustn't. Okay. And next, don't have to. That in don't have to as a modal, there is no obligation. And you are not required to do something, especially if you don't want to. For example, you don't have to ride. I can do it. There is no obligation. You have to do or you don't have to do. It is all up to you. Okay. Now, students, we also have, I also want to make you clear that there is a difference between must and mustn't. They both are not the same obligation having the same meaning. So it is very important for you all to understand the difference between these two modals. As I said, must is used to express the personal obligation. For example, you must complete your homework before evening. Now there is no there is no law, there is no your principal, school principal or your teacher saying that you must complete your homework before evening. Not at all. It's like a friend or as a mother or as a teacher, I'm just suggesting that you must complete your homework before evening and then you can play. Okay. So must is used to express an advice or a recommendation or a suggestion to someone. And mustn't means prohibited, something which is completely banned. Okay, students. For example, you mustn't carry your phone to the school. It is against the norms. Right, students, you are not allowed to carry the school mobile phones in the schools. So it's a law, it's a rule of the schools that you cannot carry the mobile phone. So there you use mustn't. You mustn't carry your mobile phones to the school. Okay. I hope that the modals are clear. So let us turn back to our exercise on page number 24. Okay, so let us solve question number one, students. Look at the extracts A to G from recording. Okay, it is related to the speaking, but we can do it as reading and writing. Now, and then match them with phrases 1 to 6. So these are some of the sentences which were from the recording, and you have to match with the phrases that is from 1 to 6. So let us do it. And in besides over here, you all are going to write the correct answer, that is 1, 2, or 3, as we are going to discuss it now. Yes. So, let's begin. You should take warm clothes. Okay, so which phrase is suitable over there? You should take warm clothes. The answer is, it's a good idea. So you will write 6 in front of A over here. You will write 6. Next, you really need a windproof coat. So let us see which phrases go with this sentence. It's necessary. So you will write number 2 over here. Over here, you will write number 2. Next, you don't have to socialize if you don't want to. So which one, students? It's not necessary. It's up to you. Okay, don't have to, it's up to you. And D, cruise ships are not allowed to go where they like. It is number 3, it's forbidden. Forbidden means it is prohibited. It also can be one. So answer for D is 1 and 3. Both are correct, students. E. They have to take scientists to lead the excursions. So which one, students? There's no choice. The scientists have to go to lead, to take an active part in the excursion trip. So it is 1. Let's move to F1. Only small parties are permitted to land. It's allowed. It is showing allowance that only small parties are allowed. Only small parties are permitted to land. Permitted means they have been given the permission for the to do it on the land. And last, you've got to keep quiet. There's no choice. You need to keep quiet. So the answer is 1 over here for G. Need not worry, students. I'll be displaying the answers also. So don't worry. Now, you will move. Now, we'll move to question number 2. So it's the only discussion over here. So we're going to discuss it. Okay, for you all to understand where to use must and we have to use have to. So we'll start with first. I must remember to buy a newspaper on my way home. So when I talk about must, students, it is the speaker is talking to himself. Okay, he's not being asked by someone to do it. He's talking to himself that yes, I must remember. Okay. Second, the doctor says I have to try to take more exercise. So what is the obligation over here? What is it saying? The speaker is not telling out to himself, but the speaker is being told by the other person. That is over here. The doctor is the other person who is telling to the speaker. Okay. So the obligation doesn't come from the speaker. It is coming from some external person, external power, that is doctor. Next, all cars must be left in the car park, not on the road. So it's a law, okay, which states that all the cars must be parked in the parking area and not on the road. So it's depicting the law. Okay, we'll move to this corpus spot, students. Now we are going to fill. There are some sentences given with obligation and necessity. They are inappropriate. They are not correct. So we have to read each sentence and we have to make it correctly. So I'll be discussing. But once I display the answers, only then you all can make a note of it with pencil in your book. So let us see what are the errors, students. Correct the mistakes that candidates have done with the obligation and necessity. So here I'll be just underlining. So there you have to make the correction. Just besides over here, you will write the corrected answer. You needn't much space to park your car. You needn't. That's not appropriate English, students. So you don't need. Okay, so you will underline needn't, and over here besides you will write you don't need. Don't need is the answer. Second, another thing, should I take my camera with me? Should I to take my camera? So over here 2 is not necessary. So you'll just cancel this 2 and nothing else is to be done in the sentence, students. Third, you needn't smoke in this part of the restaurant. It's a no smoking area. So you needn't. No, students. We have studied about mustn't, right? It's a law. So you will write mustn't. M-U-S-T and apostrophe and then T. You mustn't smoke in this part. Fourth one. It is better when you go by car because you must not get up early. So over here, must not has to be replaced with don't have. Okay, don apostrophe t and have, have. Fifth one, we have get to the exhibition early or we won't get a ticket. So what is the error? I feel it is over here, get to the exhibition. So there is a grammatical error in the sentence. So it should be, we have to get to the exhibition early or we won't get a ticket. Sixth one, you don't have to swim off the rocks before it's dangerous. You don't have to, no students, it's prohibited. So it should be mustn't over here. Seventh, my doctor says I need to give up smoking. So need over here, something is missing. So it is, my doctor says I need to give up smoking, T-O. Next, Lisa must buy a ticket before getting on the bus. Lisa must to, no students, must is not applicable over here. So Lisa has to buy, H-A-S, has to buy. And last, I don't have to be late or I'll miss my plane. So I mustn't be late because if some person is late, the plane doesn't wait, okay? It just takes off. So it's the rule or the norm of the aviation industry. So it has to be, mustn't be late. Turn your textbooks to page number 25, students. Okay. Now this part, question number 5. We have done with obligations. So this is your homework. Okay, students. You're going to solve and I'm going to display the answers in the next video on the next day. Please make a note of it with pencil, students. Now let's do this grammar extra. Now, we have studied about different parts of speech right from our lower standards, that is noun, pronoun, adverbs, verbs, preposition, conjunctions, and so on. Now here we have to do with prepositions, students. Now what exactly is the role of you? We all know that what are prepositions, like to, in, you know, across, onto, into, and so on. But students, what does a preposition do? Okay, preposition tells or it describes the position of the noun. Please make a note. Prepositions describes the position of the noun. For example, the book is under the table. So over here, students, in the sentence, book is noun. Where it is under the table. So under is the preposition which is describing the position of the book, that is the position of the noun. Always remember. So we need to complete these blanks with choosing the correct prepositions from the bracket over here. Okay, so let us begin solving together, students. The hotel had a swimming pool dash its roof. So it is on its roof, up. So it is on. I arrived dash the airport very early in the morning. So I arrived at the airport. Where did you arrive? I arrived at the airport. Third, when I asked dash the hotel, I was amazed by the decoration. Sorry, when I walked across, across means going in, inside in the hotel. So when I walked across, or we can even say when I walked into the hotel, across and into, both are correct, students. So you all can write both the answers. Fourth one, I arrived dash Spain last Tuesday. So I arrived in Spain, I-N, in. Fifth one, we showed our passports as we went dash the frontier. As we went across the frontier. The person at the front desk, okay, is called as frontier. Sixth, I found a bank dash the town center. I found a bank in the town center. So bank over here is the noun and in is the position telling that where did we find the bank? We found in the town center. Next, we sat dash the terrace drinking coffee. So we sat on the terrace drinking coffee. Next, there was a notice dash the wall telling us about trips. So there was a notice on the wall. O-N. On the wall. Second last, I jumped into the pool to cool off. Into. Inside. And last, Singapore is an island off the coast of Malaysia. I hope that we all are done till here, students. Now, this part. Question number 6 is going to be your homework. We all have done a lot about this question. So, this question, you're going to do the homework of it. Okay? Now, you will turn your textbooks to page number 26. Now, what are you going to do in this? We have studied about the word formations, students, right? Suffixes and prefixes. So, you are going to solve this question, that is question number 1 to question number 6. Okay, you are going to solve these questions on your own. So, it's again your homework. You have to add prefix. Now, what are prefixes, students? Prefixes are the affix or the words or two words which you end before the main verb. For example, we'll do this. Satisfied. And if you have been asked to add a prefix, so you have to select prefix from here. So it is unsatisfied. Okay. Second, patient. Prefix, impatient. Im is there over here. So you're going to do the prefix and the suffix exercises on your own, students. Let me also teach you let me also help you in recalling what are suffixes. Now, suffixes are the words which you end after the main word. For example, we'll make, and you have to choose the suffix from the options given over here. For example, happy. Okay, so it will be happiness. Right, students? So, ness you are adding at the end. Or we can say, pay over here. Okay? So, if you have been asked to add the suffix, so payment. Okay, so you have to make the prefixes and suffixes which we have done as a part of your adjectives in the grammar guide. So it's a revision or a practice for you all students to do it on your own. Need not worry, in the next video I'll be displaying the answers as well. Now we'll move to question number 7, which is on page number 27. Now what you're supposed to do over your students? It is less common. Okay, now you have been given... Okay, part 1 is again your prefixes or your suffixes over here. So this you can do. And moving to part 2, students, over here. Okay, now in this what you have to do is these are the verbs which are given, that is from H to K. And what you have to do is you have to change these verbs into nouns. So how it will be? Now the verb is communicate. And the noun of this verb communicate is communication. Okay. So please write it on top of it. Communication. Next. Identify. So what's the noun? It is identification. Next. Measure. So what's the noun, students? Measurement. You can pause the video, you can write it, and then you can play again. Next, introduce. So the noun is introduction. I'll display the answers for it, students. Need not worry. Satisfy. The noun is satisfaction. criticize, the noun will be criticism. C-R-I-T-I-C-I-S-M. Criticism. And last, maintain. So the noun would be maintenance. M-A-I-N-T-E-N-A-N-C-E. Maintenance. I hope that much is clear, students, and I hope that you all have written. Now we'll solve our question number 8. Yes, students, now let's move to exercise 8. So we have done this earlier also, students. So it's a revision that we all will do it together. Now there is an extract and you have been given blanks, and in front of each blank you have the options over here, which is bold. Now students, now in order to complete those blanks, it is important that you might have to change the form of these verbs, okay? About these words, okay? So we will do it together so that you all could understand. So first one is done for us, students. For published, they have written as publication. So in 1538, the publication of the world map showed North and South America as separate continents for the first time. The man who dashed this important map. So the man who produced, it is product given over here. So you cannot just directly use product, students. It is making no sense in the question. So the man who produced this important map was called Gurgis Mercator. Mercator spent his dash, young, no. So it is youth. Youth means young days, okay? So he spent his youth in Flanders, where he became known as an extremely talented map maker. Students, if I'm going at a fast pace, you all can pause and you all can write the answers. Besides teaching mathematics to the students at the University of Leuven, he also earned extra money making dash instruments. So the option given over here is science. So you have to make it a noun, that is scientific instruments. In 1544, he was briefly imprisoned for his religious beliefs and fearing for his family's safety. Okay, you all can see, students, it's quite easy. In front of the blank itself, you have the word and you have to change the form of the word. Form of the word means it could be changed into noun, it could be changed into adjective, verb or an adverb, depending upon the need of the sentence. He went to live in the Rhineland, where he remained for the rest of his life. Mercator's youngest son, Romuald, became his father's representative. Okay? Representative after his death in 1594, supervising the appearance of the first complete edition of the Mercator World Atlas the following year. Although Mercator constantly updated his maps with new information, some were wrong because the earth is round. As maps are flat, it is virtually impossible. So I have added a prefix to this word, im. Okay, so impossible to show the right scale, area and direction on one map. I hope that you all have done this question with me, students. Now I'll take you to the answer key. Yes, students, here is the answer key for you all. You all can have a look at the answers. How they're supposed to be written. I'm scrolling down this the images. You all can please pause the video and note the answers at your pace with pencil. And I will be telling you all that which lessons are to be uploaded on the drive. You all have to scan, turn it into JPG format and then only upload it on the drive. Over here, right hand side, collocation. So this question number 6, the answers I have reflected over here, students. You all can have a look. These are about your modals. So I've displayed the answers. This is about the preposition which we have done. And here is your last page. I hope the lessons and the concepts of grammar were quite easy, because we all have done it earlier and we have done it in Grammar Gear book as well. So kindly complete your homework, students, and also complete your textbook, complete the answers as we have discussed through the video. And students, do not forget to mark your attendance, your full name, your class and division. That's it for today, students. We'll meet again with the next video. Thank you.